Happy Monday. I mean, happy Wednesday. Today I'm reviewing an app called Monday, which is named after everyone's least favorite app of the week, so that they could ironically be like, hey, I love Mondays. You don't think I didn't see what you did there? I'm gonna see what you do in the app, though, before I get too angry. So Monday.com is a pretty great team application that has a couple different options. So there is the basic, which is up to two seats, and it's the individual, which is free. And then there is basic, which has $24 a month, basically, because it's required of three seats minimum. So it's $8 per seat. Then standard is $10 a month and three seats minimum as well. So the reason that you'd want to go for the standard over the basic is because there's timeline, Gantt views, a calendar view, which is obviously big. You can have guest access and automations and integrations. So I think that dashboards are also really important whenever you're doing anything like this. So obviously you're going to want to try to figure out something in that sense. So you can see how much things would cost, obviously, if you change the number of seats. But if we go into this, you need a work email address to sign up. So it's sign up here. Let's do this email. Now you can do things for work, personal, school, nonprofits. But I'm personally gonna pretend like this is for work. What bit describes your current load? Business owner. So to get started off, it tries to get you to find your first template that you wanna use here. So let's do an example of a request template just to show you some of the functionality that exists here. It's going to start me off with a free trial, so I'll be able to show you a lot of what's going on. So first and foremost, if you go into the bottom left here, you can change it to dark mode or night mode, which I know a lot of people really like dark and night mode, so I figured I'd point that out. So first of all, if we want to get into a couple of different looks at the different views we have, we can add these different views here. So if we go, we can add a group to the board, we could add a column to the board, and we have all these different crazy options. It's a very advanced app, so I'm trying to do my best to showcase the different parts of it. So actually, let's start off with just a new board here, because you have an option between boards, dashboards, docs, and forms, which are in beta currently. Let's do a new board here. And as you can see, it's kind of a table view that's going on. So obviously you can, as you saw earlier, add groups, columns, views. So if I added a view, I can change it to being a dashboard view. And then you can toggle between the different views on the top here, showcasing some of the other views. There's obviously things like timelines, file views, so that you can see what files are within said board. A nice calendar view to see from a different view how the different parts of this board break out from a date standpoint. There's a map view, a form view, a Kanban view, cards. This has nearly everything you can think of. If you want to visualize your data using a chart, you can as well. So this can showcase to you a lot of different views on a chart front. And then if we go into docs real quick, you can actually see that this is something that they're really happy with, they're really proud of. This is something that they made a few months back. So if we look into how docs are, write something or type slash for more options. So it's similar to Notion, that there's that plus on the side and then you have all these different options for things. So there are actually ways to make tables in here. You do slash board. You can pull through boards into documents here. So it's like an inline thing almost. And then obviously there's all these basic functionalities with like dividers, the bulleted list, the normal text, the images, video embeds, widget embeds as well. Choose a widget like a Gantt widget and then pull it from a board. So this is really nice that these documents can be sent across teams as well. And then they kind of take inline views of these different boards and whatnot. And you can send that probably is great that you can do this, because then you can send these views to clients and whatnot, and you can actually have a nice little view of everything going on. And it can be nice to use for an agenda as well if you're in a meeting. Now, some of the integrations that exist here are, I mean, there's so many integrations with. So if you go into the bottom left and click on your profile and then press Apps Marketplace, you can actually see that there are a bunch of third-party applications that can connect with the Monday software as well. So you can actually have Figma embedded in here, Gliffy, Track It, all these different things. There's time tracking solutions for Monday. There's a lot of different HTML embed stuff. It's crazy. GitHub obviously has an integration with a lot of software, and it has one here. You can have CRM things in here. Let's do some of the featured lookups here. There's a VLOOKUP system that you can integrate in here. Now, from an automation standpoint, you can create custom motivations, which are pretty interesting to me. So basically, this is an if-then sort of situation, and you can do a lot of different things, like every time period that occurs, you can create an item. So that's recurring tasks. Obviously, you can notify people on certain times. So rather than this being like a bunch of different separate functionality, it's this one main automation center. So you can obviously automate things by specific boards too. You can obviously see that there's the option to, when a status changes to something, assign someone an assignee. So when a status changes, to working on it, assign me as the assignee. So then in that situation, if I made a new item example, and then I changed it to working on it, I would get assigned it. So you can see it's basically a very crazy level of automation where you can just do like natural language processing and figure out what you want to do. And then you can add a description to what this means. And then you can see your account usage on what you have per month. So if we go into the bottom left one again, once again, and click on integrations, you can see all these different options here. So I'll give an example of a Google Calendar one, because there's just so many integrations, and add it to that new board I made. So you can do things like when an item is created or updated, create an event in Google Calendar and sync future changes from this board. When a person is assigned, create an event in Google Calendar and sync changes. When an event is created in Google Calendar, create an item and sync future changes from Google Calendar. So you can have like this one or two way sync going on here. So I want to connect it so that for this, anytime that I do something in my Google Calendar, it'll send it to Monday for that board view. So when an event is creating Google Calendar, create an item. So what you can do here is then press this plus item and then take the different properties from Google Calendar, bring it in. So for the item, you want to add the name to be the title, status doesn't really matter here, the date to be the start time, then the person is something that you could set beforehand. And the status, the item update could have an option here as well, but basically what I'm going to do here is press done, add to board, and if I go back here and go to my Google Calendar, just go to an example here, so I can do example task or example meeting. So you can see that was immediate. It set the time for it, it had the date, the time immediately, and then it has a Google Calendar sync column right here as well. So I mean, that was immediate. So if we go into the mobile app here on Monday, it's got a nice little dark mode based on the fact that my phone had that already. So if we go into that that new board view, you can obviously see that there are a little bit of a rigidity problem when it comes to things like these apps. A lot of the time, it doesn't, in my opinion, do a great job of changing the spacing well. If I go back to that main table view, not exactly the best looking thing on the planet. Especially if we do things like calendar views, not a great look. The dashboard view, the file view, it looks okay actually. And then let's say if we add a Kanban view or something, it's okay. Like, I just don't like how the sizing doesn't change much. And that happens with a lot of these apps where I think Notion does a decent job of it, but you know, you need to like do some fancy stuff with the navigation, but the sizing on this isn't amazing. The docs for this, I'm sure are fine. A new doc that you can see here with what I had going on, it's gonna have all these inlines ones in here. And regarding this, the Gantt view is only supported on the desktop, so you can't even see that kind of stuff. The mobile view, from what I can tell, I think would be decent if, like, say we add a, as decent as, I guess if we had a view that was a little bit smaller. But for me, I don't think that the mobile view is great. It's nice to see the table sort of, and that's decent, and like some side scrolling is okay. I'm not gonna complain about that. But for the most part, I don't really like the way that a lot of these look. And as well as the charts obviously aren't viewable on mobile. So the mobile view is just very limited. I mean, I don't even, the battery works, but like I said, it doesn't really give you a lot of nice functionality on the mobile app. You're pretty much gonna have to use the desktop app outside of like basic task management and tables, because I don't really see a lot of the nice things about Monday and the crazy things that it can do working well for you on the mobile app.
If you like this video, make sure to click on that one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.